Today, I'm gonna discuss making an offer on a house contingent on selling yours. Stay tuned because at the end of the video, I'll share a list of tips when selling a home. You won't wanna miss it. I'm Kristin Stampini with StampTV, and thanks for tuning into my channel. Let's get started. Making an offer that you execute only if you're able to sell your home may seem like the best of all possible worlds, but there are likely to be some catches when doing that. Time limits. The seller isn't going to wait forever for you to make a good on your offer and contingent offer on a house that you should specify a time limit, usually around 60 days or less. While this can buy you some extra time, you may still be fighting the calendar as you work to sell your existing home. You can also have a kickout clause. A contingent agreement may include a kickout clause, which can shorten the time period considerably. A kickout clause can require you to commit to your offer possibly within 48 or 72 offers, or else the home seller becomes free to accept a competing offer if somebody else makes an offer. Competitive impact speaking of competing offers, be advised that home sellers are likely to view contingent offers as less attractive than those with no strings attached at all. All things being equal in terms of the amount of the offer and credit qualifications, a would-be buyer making a contingent offer is likely to lose out if the seller also has an offer on the table from someone who is ready to fully commit today. So selling and buying a house at the same time may be complicated, but it can also be easier if you are working with professionals and real estate agents who are familiar with this and know how to do it really well. The process to guide you through which approach process is best suited for your situation. Now, as a seller, it also helps if you are prepared to do everything you can to make sure your property sells and closes quickly sometimes, because unless you have a substantial financial resources to carry two mortgages, which most people don't at once, timing is likely to be an issue to some extent. So selling and buying a house at the same time, perhaps you're relocating for a job opportunity and upgrading from a starter house or downsizing after your kids leave the nest. For whatever the reason for moving, the decision you're faced with quickly turns into kind of chicken or the egg dilemma, right? You know, do you put your house on the market before finding your new home? Or do you get something lined up before you sell your current property? That's the question. Chances are, house hunting and putting your home on the market may overlap to some degree, and you might even find yourself in the position of making an offer on a house before selling yours. If so, there are a few ways that you can approach it. And I'm gonna just talk about that. You can pick your closing dates carefully. If you have a fairly standard property in a high demand real estate market, you may just get lucky. You might be able to get a firm offer and setting a closing date that is within the actual window before you have to make a financial commitment to your new purchase. You know, unfortunately, there is a lot that can go wrong during the closing process, and not all properties can be quickly sold, like applying for FHA eligibility rule exception. FHA mortgage loans generally have the most generous credit standards, but they also have rules restricting you from qualifying for a new FHA mortgage while you have existing FHA loan. However, if an FHA loan offers you best chance at qualifying from a credit standpoint, you may have some leeway. FHA eligibility rules allow you to qualify for a new mortgage if you are relocating more than 100 miles from your existing property for work reasons. And if you can demonstrate that the current property no longer meets your needs to growth in your family, or if you're moving from a property your own jointly with a co-borrower who will remain in the property. So there's multiple things. You know, try to meet conventional mortgage loan debt to income requirements. If you can't meet FHA eligibility rule, or if your credit is good enough for you to get less expensive conventional loan, the most important obstacle you face might be the debt to income requirement. And this limits the amount your total debt payments can represent as a percentage of your income. In most cases, the maximum debt to income ratio for a conventional loan may be 45%, maybe a little bit higher or lower. And it may be lower if you don't have very strong credit history. So unless you have a high income, it can be difficult to keep your debt to income ratio below the limit you take on as an additional mortgage, even if it's only until you sell your existing home. A leaseback is another option. If you can find a buyer who isn't in a huge hurry to move into your existing home, you can actually try to negotiate a lease agreement that allows you to stay in the home property while you wait to close on your new home. However, be sure the lease terms don't tie you up for too long, or you could find yourself making lease payments in addition to actual mortgage payments on your new home. Also, this kind of provision isn't going to be attractive necessarily to everyone. Could limit the pool of potential buyers you have. You have to work with an experienced agency in all of this, making a contingent offer perhaps the most common and least complicated way of buying a house before selling your existing one. But this isn't going to happen in all markets. And if the house you're making an offer on is basically a lot of people want it, they're not going to accept your offer binding you on the sale of your existing home. There's a lot of tricky things that can happen when doing this. Working with experienced professionals is a must during this process. And somebody who has done this multiple times that can assist you with the process. Make sure you're picking somebody that can help you. Thanks again for tuning into my channel. I hope you like this video. And if so, don't forget, hit the thumbs up. Leave a comment and subscribe to my channel. Also, click the bell icon so you'll receive instant notifications for new episodes every single Tuesday. And if you would like a list of tips when purchasing a home, leave a comment below, private message me, and I'll be happy to send it to you right away. Thanks for tuning in to Stamp TV. Have a great day.